ready to meet our delegates? This time the question is for real. Are you ready to meet our delegates? And let me just brief you on just how it all began. In 1992, Dan Sri Dr. Danny Ui started the very first Miss Southeast Asia Tourism Ambassadress Final, which was held here in Kuala Lumpur with the participation of 14 delegates from 6 countries. The show was set to raise the standard and platform to promote tourism and culture exchanges among the Southeast Asian nations by fostering friendship and goodwill amongst these countries and beyond. This year, we have 16 delegates from 9 ASEAN countries. And ladies and gentlemen, they bring together a spread of united spirit and peace to the world. The title is supported by the Ministry of Tourism Malaysia. And ladies and gentlemen, once again, I would like to turn your attention first and foremost to our star-studded judging table. And I'd like to reintroduce you to our judges. So, a round of applause for these amazing individuals who have the very difficult task this evening of piecing together scorecards that will determine who takes away the title. Let me reintroduce you to actor, host, singer, model, Fear Factor, Celebrity Malaysia champion and entrepreneur, Dasrin Kamarudin. He is flagged by Zoe Tan, movie producer, actress and Miss Malaysia Queen of Tourism 1996. Warang Kanang Utiakon, Miss Tourism Queen of the Year International 2014-2015 from Thailand. Irene Leong, Vice President International Affairs of D-Touch International, our Chief Judge. Phan Huong Tu, Miss Southeast Asia 2013-2014 from Vietnam. CEO of Corona Group of Companies, founder of R&G Consultancy and Miss Malaysia Intercontinental 1993, Rachel Ng. And rounding up the panel, we have Raja Mukris, Raja Ahmad Kamarudin, film director, cinematographer, and producer. Well, I've kept you waiting in anticipation long enough. It is now truly time to meet the delegates as they take the stage. So ladies and gentlemen, introducing to you for the very first time on this stage, the delegates of the lovely tourism pageant that you're about to witness. Please help us welcome our 16 delegates of the Miss Southeast Asia Tourism Ambassadress 2015. A big round of applause.
Time has now begun. Open your eyes and see the change in you and me. Now as one, living under the sun. Hear the children sing, the hope their voices bring.
One ASEAN, one vision, one people we care. Ignited, united, a brotherhood of man. One voice, one rhythm, in harmony we sing. Across generations, one family we stand.
A strength unbound, did it destined to shake the crown. Bonds entwined, blessed be the tie that binds. A point of a life.
Ladies and gentlemen, introducing the delegates of Miss Southeast Asia Tourism Ambassadress 2015 from Cambodia. Introducing Patna Pan. And Shrelik Van.
Malaysia truly Asia.
Next from Indonesia. Introducing Valentina Cotton.
Now is the time for fascination. Malaysia, it's unforgettable. This is the year of.
And Vivian Anjani Suito. The delegates from Laos. Introducing Santakni Sai Makniwan. And Sudapon Sikaipak. Ladies and gentlemen, the delegates from Myanmar. Introducing Nin Nadi Chu.
This is the year of endless celebrations.
And Shane BX Sontet. Introducing the delegates from the Philippines. Ladies and gentlemen, Alexandra May Rosales. Rowena Sasaluya. The delegate from Singapore. Ladies and gentlemen, Rachel Cole. The delegates from Thailand. Introducing Yada Te Pakno. And Kopkol Bunrong. The delegate from Vietnam.
This is the year of endless celebrations.
Malaysia truly is.
Ladies and gentlemen, Grantee Queen Nga. And now the delegates from the host nation, Malaysia. Introducing Joey Ong IE. And Shirley Hughes. Ladies and gentlemen, a big round of applause for the 16 delegates of the Miss Southeast Asia Tourism Ambassadress 2015. Put your hands together, ladies and gentlemen. Show some love for our 16 delegates. Thank you, ladies. You're looking absolutely amazing this evening in your national costume. And the judges have already decided who has taken the first salvo at this event by winning the Best in National Costume. On that note, it is now my pleasure to invite Yang Berbahagia Tan Sri Dato' Danny Ui to accompany our guest of honor, Yang Berbahagia Dato' Chua Kok Ching, the Deputy Secretary General, Ministry of Transport Malaysia, to present the very first title, Best in National Costume. Ladies and gentlemen, Best in National Costume. This title goes to, from Myanmar, Shan Piek Santan. Congratulations, Shane, on picking up the very first subsidiary title of the evening. Come on, ladies and gentlemen, a big round of applause for Shane on picking up a first subsidiary title. Thank you to our distinguished guest of honor for presenting the very first subsidiary title. Now, to introduce this round, I gotta introduce you to Malaysian Batik. It's art on silk, and it's mostly large floral motifs, light and variant in coloring. This evening, we'd like to thank My Batik Collection for being a big part of the next round. So, ladies and gentlemen, let's put our hands together and warmly welcome back our 16 delegates as they take the stage in the Batik round. A big round of applause, ladies and gentlemen. Ladies and gentlemen, need I say more? Put your hands together for our amazing delegates. I know it's really difficult being a delegate. You have to coordinate movements, steps, learn dances, catwalk, and even prepare for the very grueling final question round. So it's not really easy being a delegate because you got to do all that, look good, and outshine everybody else. So I think our delegates deserve another big round of applause. Come on, everybody, put your hands together. Thank you very much. Yes, ladies and gentlemen, our delegates did a lot more than put on makeup and look pretty every day. They actually did tours, visited the beautiful city of Putrajaya, Kuala Lumpur City Gallery, and also Akroya KLCC. And they put on some high heels like they did just now on stage and went on parade. at the Faruni Gallery. So we're going to take you through some of the fun stuff they got to do while here in beautiful Malaysia, visiting the many sights and sounds that truly make Malaysia, well, Malaysia. So ladies and gentlemen, we'd like to direct your attention to the screens as we roll for you some of the tours and fun activities of our delegates while here in beautiful Malaysia. Take a look.
If I wanna, just by my attitude, I can take my laptop, record a snapshot, and change your point of view. I just entered this brand new world, and I'm so open-hearted. I know I've got a long way to go, but I'm just getting started. I'm over my head, and I know it, I know it. I'm doing my best not to show it, to show it. Whatever it takes to be what I was meant to be, I'm gonna try. 'Cause I'm living the dream, and I know it, I know it. I'm trying my best not to blow it, to blow it. And I know everything will be fine with me, myself. Some days it makes me want to change my direction. Sometimes it gets lonely, but I know that it's only a matter of my perception. I just entered this brand new world, and I'm so open-hearted. I know I've got a long way to go, but I'm just getting started. I'm over my head, and I know it, I know it. I'm doing my
looks like our delegates had some time to unwind, and boy did they have fun. Look at the smiles on their faces. And by the way, ladies and gentlemen, you can actually use the hashtag Tourism Ambassadress or Detouch International to upload any photos that you might have of this event. If you happen to snag a selfie with one of our delegates, we want to see that selfie to send it our way. And in fact, this evening there'll also be a subsidiary title for most sociable delegate on social media. So ladies and gentlemen, moving quickly along, we've got something really special lined up momentarily. Now, in every pageant, there's always the talent round, and it's kind of grueling. To be honest, as a delegate, it is quite a chore to even do everything that you've already seen them do. And on top of that, they have to perform a talent of their choosing. Now, you might think that that goes without saying, but for each of these delegates to particularly pick one talent they're good at was very difficult because they're multi-talented. As you saw in the video, some of them actually are pretty good at bate chanting. Some of them are also great at dancing. There's even a magician amongst our delegates this evening. So we're just about to see which one is going to be crowned best talent. Now, we've divided the talent round into several pots. And this evening, judges, what you'll be seeing are the top seven from amongst the best talent performers within our delegates. You'll be witnessing cultural dance medleys. You'll also be witnessing a rap superstar in the making. One of our delegates will be attempting to rap. And we'll have a live trumpet recital. Now, the background music for this trumpet recital is on the piano and violin, which is also played by the delegate. Pre-recorded, but played by the delegate herself. And, of course, we have the talent that everyone is most familiar with, the art of voice. One of our delegates will be singing, and she speaks quite a particularly fast song, Love You Like a Love Song, that will be coming up later. And to round everything up, as I promised, we'll be having an illusion or magic illusion performance. So these are the talents that you will be bearing witness to, and the girls are ready. So I can stop talking now, and I can introduce you to the first performance, which is a medley of three cultural dance performances. Judges, get ready to be blown away by Cambodia's Srilek Van, Indonesia's Vivian Anjadi, and from Laos, Santani Semaneva. A round of applause for Cambodia's Sri Lekvan, Indonesia's Vivian Anjani, and Laos's Santani Semaneva. And that was a cultural medley. I will admit, ladies and gentlemen, dancing is beyond me. I'm one of those people born with two left feet. But I've been known to bust a rhyme on the occasion. So I'm very eager to see what our next performer is going to be doing, because she is going to be attempting to rap and sing at the same time. Ladies and gentlemen, please help us welcome all the way from Indonesia, Valentina Cotton.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I'm gonna tell you the story about love in my life. I was born in Indonesia. The capital city is Jakarta. And this Jakarta was like this.
Matahari bersinar indah, menyinari bumi tercinta ini. Suku budaya dan wisata, akulturasi indah tercipta. Jakartaku kota megapolitan, Jakartaku tempat aku berpijak. Jakartaku kota harapan, oh bagi semua kau berikan semangatmu. Jakartaku kota dengan sejuta impian, Jakartaku berkaryalah selalu. Kebanggaan bumi-bumi berdiri, Jakarta, aku cinta padamu.
And as I grow older, I realize in this world, there are so many war, terrorism, corruption. And it got me thinking like, where is the love? Here we go. What's wrong with the world, mama? People living like they ain't got no mama. I think the whole world addicted to this drama, only attracted to the things that will bring you trauma. Overseas, yeah, we try to stop terrorism, but we still got terrorists here living. In the USA, the big CIA, the Blood and the Crips and the KKK. But you only have love for your own race, then you only give space to discriminate. And to discriminate only generates hate. And when you hate, you are bound to get irate. Yeah, madness is what you demonstrate, and that's exactly how anger works and operates. Man, you gotta have love just to set it straight. Take control over mind and meditate, let the soul gravitate to the love, yo. And this love is the weapon to create peace. This love never failed to make me feel loved. It's my mother's love to me. She's sitting right there now. And I'm gonna tell you something. To always think, mama, that what? This is for you, mom. Shopping, yo. This is for your window when how? Wish a mom. Parents, I not can man, hua. What you say, shui, hua, hua. The chicken, she, shua, hua. Parents, I want you see. What I call, chow, 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 chow,
但却得到很多小小的危机，为什么要听妈妈的话？长大后你就会开始懂了这段话啊！长后开始明白，为什么我跑得别人快，飞得别人高，将来他想看的都是我画的漫画。大家看的都是我写的歌，妈妈的幸福不让你看见，我懒得生物，在他心里面有空就多多握握他的手，把手心子一起梦游。
Ladies and gentlemen, another round of applause for our delegate from Indonesia, Valentina Cotton. And I caught one of the judges rapping along with her. So I guess we know which talent you're picking for now. But you haven't seen them all yet, because ladies and gentlemen, up next, our next delegate will be playing the trumpet solo. And as I mentioned earlier, backing up this performance is a piano and violin, which is also played by her. It's pre-recorded, but it's played by her nevertheless. So please help me welcome the very talented Mozart in the making, Rachel Cole from Singapore. Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen from Singapore, Rachel Ko. Up next, our next delegate will attempt to sing her heart out for you. All the way from Thailand, ladies and gentlemen, please help us welcome Kopko Bunrong.
It's been said and done, every beautiful.
Ladies and gentlemen, now traditionally, the magician's assistant is the pretty one. And the pretty magician's assistant is there for a reason, to distract you from the actual trick while the magician is preparing his craft. Well, this evening, magic will be performed with a slight twist, because the pretty one is the magician. So will she have a handsome assistant? I am not sure, but ladies and gentlemen, a very interesting performance to await. Please welcome from Malaysia, Joey Ong, our illusionist.
Thank you.
Let's give it up for our magician, Joey Ong from Malaysia, and the assistant, Shirley Hugh, also one of our delegates. I'd consider Joey Ong to be very dangerous competition if she can levitate any of the delegates at will. So, well, ladies and gentlemen, that kind of wraps up our talent round. The best seven have performed for you this evening, and the judges will decide from amongst these seven which of the delegates take home the subsidiary title of best talent. Now, pageantry is not just about the glamour. It's also about giving back. And as cliche as it sounds, when the very first Miss Universe was crowned and she said world peace, many believe she sincerely meant it. World peace cannot be achieved by just a wish. There's got to be loads of action behind it. And our delegates have gone the distance while they were here. They were part of the Because We Care initiative, a CSR program where the delegates visited Taman Mega Handicap and Disabled Children's Home. This next video will take you through their journey and experiences as they managed to be a part of these children's lives, even though they were here for a very short time. So we direct your attention now to this video playback on our CSR initiative with our delegates. Take a look, ladies and gentlemen. We'd like to thank the Taman Mega Handicap and Disabled Children's Home for being so welcoming to our delegates. And we truly hope that the short time that our delegates had to spend with their children had made a difference in their lives. Now, ladies and gentlemen, we will be moving on to the next round. The star-studded, glamour-filled round. This is the evening wear round, where you see our delegates all decked out in gorgeous gowns. And this round will be the final round before we move on to presenting you our final seven from among 16 delegates competing this evening. So on that note, ladies and gentlemen, please put your hands together and help us welcome back to the stage our 16 delegates of the Miss Southeast Asia Tourism Ambassadress 2015. A round of applause. Let's show them some love. Ladies and gentlemen, from Cambodia, Patna Pan. She's 22 and enjoys swimming and singing. Sreelik Van, she's 23, enjoys listening to music, reading, and exercising. Our delegates from Indonesia, Valentina Cotton. She's 23, enjoys traveling, basketball, cooking, and public speaking. Vivian Anjadi Suito. She's also 23, enjoys traveling, and back home, she's a TV presenter. Let's meet our delegates from Laos. Santakni Sai Makniwan. She's 22, enjoys dancing, sport, and traveling. And Sudapon Sikaipak. She's 22, enjoys reading, dancing, and listening to music. Ladies and gentlemen, introducing our delegates from Myanmar. Nin Nadichu, she's 22, enjoys swimming, dancing, singing, reading, and traveling. And Shane Pierre Sontet, she's 18, enjoys traveling, yoga, and reading. Let's meet our delegates, ladies and gentlemen. From the next two countries, these are delegates from the Philippines. Uh-huh. Introducing from the Philippines, Alexandra May Rosales. She's 19, enjoys playing the guitar, singing, and dancing. Also from the Philippines, Rowena Sasaluya. She's 21, enjoys reading historical and cultural books. Introducing our delegate from Singapore, Rachel Cole. She's 25, enjoys playing the piano and traveling. Introducing our delegates from Thailand. Yada Tepatnu. She's 23, enjoys playing Sudoku, swimming, exercising, and dancing. And Kopkul Bunrang. She's 23 and enjoys reading motivational books. Next, introducing our delegate from Vietnam, Nguyen Thi Quyen Nga. She's 20 and enjoys traveling. And our delegates from the host nation, Malaysia. Introducing Joey Ong Ai. She's 25 and enjoys outdoor activities. And Shirley Hugh, she's 25, enjoys cooking, swimming, and socializing. Ladies and gentlemen, let's give them another warm round of applause, please. Aren't they gorgeous? You're all looking lovely, ladies, and truly, I do not envy the judges because it's really difficult to pick from among you the top seven. But the judges have done their job, and we have now got our top seven. So ladies and gentlemen, in no particular order, we introduce to you the top seven of the Miss Southeast Asia Tourism Ambassadress 2015. A round of applause for Valentina Cotton from Indonesia. Santani Semaniva from Laos. Shirley Hugh from Malaysia. Nin Nadi Chu from Myanmar. Alexandra May Rosales from the Philippines. Rachel Cole from Singapore. And our final finalist in the top seven, ladies and gentlemen, Yada Tepaknom from Thailand. Please join me, ladies and gentlemen, congratulating our top seven and thanking the rest of our delegates. Thank you, ladies. We will see you shortly. Well, ladies and gentlemen, our top seven are now on stage, and they do have just one final round. Well, this to some is the most grueling round, but to others, it's the most anticipated round, where we get to hear our delegates speak for the very first time. Besides the talent round, of course. It's the most grueling round for me, because I'm standing next to them. Now, I told them during the rehearsals, whatever you do, don't smile at me, because I will just forget everything. So let's start the final round, ladies and gentlemen. This is the much anticipated question and answer round. So we'll start off with our delegate from Indonesia, Valentina. Would you kindly step forward? Hi, how you doing?
Good.
How's the weather out there?
Yeah, it's been such a great week. They are all very friendly. We are now become a gang of happy girls. I love them.
Yeah, you can follow them on social media and you'll see what she's saying is true. And that wasn't the question. The question that we have for you in this final round, Valentina, is if you are selected as Miss Southeast Asia Tourism Ambassadress, how will you promote ASEAN to the world? You have 20 seconds.
Thank you for the question. Firstly, I will travel around ASEAN and post my traveling pictures to the social media to inform and educate people and the world about how great our culture and tourism. And I wish I can be the inspiration to visit ASEAN, just like Mahatma Gandhi said, be the change you want to see in the world. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, judges, Valentina Cotton from Indonesia. Thank you for your answer, Valentina. Move on to our next contestant, ladies and gentlemen, Shirley Hugh from Malaysia. Hi there, Shirley, looking lovely this evening. Are you nervous?
Yes, kind of, but I'm confident.
Atta girl. Same question for you. If you're selected as Miss Southeast Asia Tourism Ambassadress, how would you promote ASEAN to the world? You also have 20 seconds.
To refer to Asia, I believe it is through cultural and economics, and which I feel both of these things is related and is connected to tourism. Hence, if let's say I'm the winner, I will try to travel most of the ASEAN country and I will write a blog or I will do a video clip in order to promote the religion, culture, and also the food and transportation in different ASEAN countries. Also, in economic point of view, I believe logistics and transport is really important and play a major role. Hence, I would like to use my title, make use of my title to promote how effective and how efficiency of the transport and logistics in all the ASEAN countries. I believe this will be the best way and one of the way to promote One Asia, One Vision, One People We Care. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Shirley. Ladies and gentlemen, Shirley Hugh from Malaysia. Moving on, ladies and gentlemen, from the Philippines, we have Alexandra May Rosales. Thank you for joining us here in Malaysia. Now, they say it's more fun in the Philippines. Is that true?
Well, it's more fun in ASEAN.
Nicely answered. And the same question applies to you as well. If you were selected as Miss Southeast Asia Tourism Ambassadress, how would you promote ASEAN in 20 seconds?
It is the greatest opportunity for me to win the title, and for that I would promote, and for that I would promote the ASEAN for in a way of unity. How it is to have an activity not only by made by me but also for my fellow candidates, because I believe that the true unity would be shown if all us ASEAN with my lovely candidates would be joining the campaign, not only for the winner, but all of us would promote the unity, the power of unity of all the among all ASEAN countries. That would be all. Thank you.
Judges Alexandra May Rosales from the Philippines. Thank you for your answer. We move on. Ladies and gentlemen, our next finalist is Yada Tepangnum from Thailand. Sawadee kap. Welcome to Malaysia. And the same question applies to you. If you were selected as Miss Southeast Asia Tourism Ambassadress, how would you promote ASEAN in 20 seconds?
I would like to present ASEAN as the land of diversity and opportunities. I will show the unique blend of cultures, religions, and the articulate art of ASEAN. And I believe that I can promote the opportunity in investment in ASEAN, such as the transportation, the choice of skilled labor, the natural resources, and the political stability through the social network and any campaigns that I participate. Thank you.
Thank you, judges Yada Tepangnum from Thailand. And now, ladies and gentlemen, we get to be reacquainted with a very talented musician, Rachel Cole from Singapore. Hi, Rachel. Welcome to the North. How are you doing?
I'm very good. How's everyone?
How's everyone? You guys okay? Same question for you, Rachel. If you're selected as Miss Southeast Asia Tourism Ambassadress, how would you promote ASEAN in 20 seconds?
Thank you for the question. Good evening, everyone. So as we all know, in the ASEAN culture, we value collectivism. We are one big family. So I would say that we have the warmest and friendliest community in the world, as shown by our past week over here in Malaysia. Thank you, Malaysia. Thank you, my Southeast Asian family. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, judges Rachel Cole from Singapore. We move on to our next finalist from Myanmar, Nin Nadichu. Nin, wow, you're really high up there. Don't be fooled, it's just because I don't have any hair. Same question for you, Nin. If you're selected as Miss Southeast Asia Tourism Ambassadress, how would you promote ASEAN in 20 seconds?
I have two answers. First one is being a beauty queen in promoting tourism in ASEAN country, combining entertainment and health and to have more exhibition and entertainment, and then traveling around the Southeast Asia country to attend this event. And I'm so excited. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Nin, for the effort. Judges, Nin Naricho from Myanmar, which leaves only our final finalist, Santani Se Magniva from Laos. Welcome to Malaysia. Is this your first time visiting us?
This is my first time for visiting Malaysia and the first time of Laos to join Miss Malaysian Tourism Ambassadors. So I hope I can be the best for my country and for the Asia.
Wonderful. Let's give a round of applause just for that. Thank you for participating, and the question is the same to you. If you're selected as Miss Southeast Asia Tourism Ambassadress, how would you promote ASEAN in 20 seconds?
Thank you for the question. I'm going to promote culture, tourism, transport and logistics of Laos or Malaysia is mean of ASEAN country. We'll be the good ambassadors to connecting ASEAN country to be the one, because ASEAN is the new upcoming country in the world with modern city and own cultures. Visiting ASEAN, you will experience with friendly people, good food, good life, good shopping, good traveling, and great history. Thank you, Khop Chai.
Khop Chai, thank you very much. Santani Se Magniva from Laos. I don't know if you could tell, ladies and gentlemen, but that round was more nerve-wracking for me than it was for them. They did an amazing job. Let's give them a round of applause. They can still hear you backstage. As the spotlight now turns to the judges' table, they have the arduous task of selecting a winner from amongst our seven finalists. There'll also be the subsidiary titles, which we will be announcing momentarily. We're going to take a quick breather to continue to enjoy your dinner, ladies and gentlemen. We'll be back in just a bit. Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, are you ready? That's more like it. Put your hands together. Show some love for our delegates as they take the stage in their final lineup. Blowing us away with your presence for the final time this evening, ladies and gentlemen, our delegates, as we now move on to present the subsidiary titles. First up, Best in Social Media, and I would like to invite Yang berbahagia Dato' Michael Teo, Managing Director and Group Chief Executive of PKT Logistics Group, Sedian Prahad, to kindly take the stage to present this subsidiary. Now, you might be asking why Dato' Michael is presenting this subsidiary. And the reason is simple. He himself has 370,000 likes on his Facebook page. And after tonight, there'll be many, many more. Now, the winner of this subsidiary simply had the most posts on social media. Besides all the many get-goings of the pageant, she had time to post as many times on social media as possible, and the subsidiary for best in social media hence goes to, from Indonesia, Vivian Anjani Suito! Congratulations, Vivian. And thank you, Yang Berbahagia Dato' Michael Teo, for kindly doing the honors and sashing our subsidiary of best in social media. We move along, and I would like to invite movie producer, actress, Miss Malaysia Queen of Tourism 1996, Miss Zoe Tan, to the stage to sash best in talent. After many rounds of talent performances at the final seven you witnessed this evening, best in talent goes to Rachel Koh from Singapore. Congratulations, Rachel. And thank you very much, Ms. Zoe Tan. Moving along, I would like to invite Ms. Rachel Ng, CEO of Coronar Group of Companies, founder of RNG Consultancy, and Miss Malaysia Intercontinental 1993, to kindly take the stage to sash our next subsidiary, Miss Friendship. So ladies and gentlemen, please help us congratulate Miss Friendship from Malaysia, Joey Ong Ai. Congratulations, Joey, on a job well done as host. The many delegates from around ASEAN, and thank you, Ms. Rachel Ng. The next subsidiary is Miss Elegant, and I would like to invite Mr. C.C. Ngai, Managing Director of Rooney Ceramics in Yuan Prahad, to take the stage and sash the winner of this subsidiary. Of course, the ladies had their very own catwalk session at Ceramic, and they also perform right here on stage, showcasing their lovely evening gowns. Miss Elegant, therefore, goes to Nin Nadichu from Myanmar. Congratulations, Nin. And I would like to thank Mr. CC Ngai for kindly taking to the stage and sashing our subsidiary title. Well, ladies and gentlemen, this is the moment we've all been waiting for. The final results and the crowning of a brand new Miss Southeast Asia Tourism Ambassadress 2015. On that note, I would now like to invite Yang Berbahagia Tan Sri Dato' Danny Ui, President of Miss Southeast Asia Tourism Ambassadress, to kindly take the stage. Let's give Tan Sri a big round of applause, ladies and gentlemen. And to join Tan Sri in sashing our second runner-up, Miss Warangkanang Watayukon, Miss Tourism Queen of the Year International 2014-2015 from Thailand. Ladies and gentlemen, the second runner-up of Miss Southeast Asia Tourism Ambassadress 2015-2016 is... from Indonesia, Valentina Cotton. Congratulations. And I'd like to invite Ms. Warangkanang Watayukon to kindly remain on stage to also join the sashing and crowning of Miss Southeast Asia Tourism Ambassadress 2015-2016's first runner-up. Ladies and gentlemen, the first runner-up of our event this evening goes to Alexandra May Rosales from the Philippines! Congratulations to Alexandra. And congratulations to Valentina. And I would like to thank Ms. Warangkanang Watayukon, Ms. Tourism Queen of the Year International 2014-2015 for joining us on stage. And now to join Yang Berbahagia Tan Sri Dato' Danny Ui to crown and sash Miss Southeast Asia Tourism Ambassadress 2015-2016, I'd like to invite Miss Pan Huang Tu, Miss Southeast Asia 2013-2014 from Vietnam. Distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, Miss Southeast Asia Tourism Ambassadress 2015-2016 is Yada Tepaknom from Thailand! Congratulations to Yada Tepaknom from Thailand on being crowned Miss Southeast Asia Tourism Ambassadress 2015-2016. And what a journey awaits her as the ambassadress of tourism to ASEAN and intra-ASEAN. Ladies and gentlemen, a big round of applause as Yada Tevaknom takes her victory walk as Miss Southeast Asia Tourism Ambassadress 2015-2016. Please also join me in congratulating Valentina Cotton, our second runner-up, and Alexandra May Rosales, our first runner-up. I would like to invite all our VIPs this evening to kindly join our winners on stage for a final group photograph. I'd also like to invite back Miss Warangkanang Utayakon and Miss Phan Huang Tu to join in the photo session.
Many cultural sites.